In this video, we are going to continue the CAD model we were talking from last video and specifically talk about the production process and how to make this ring into this one. Are you ready? Let's get started. If you haven't watched this video, how to make this model, don't forget to watch it first. This video is about the production process that's starting with 3D printing. There are different kinds of 3D printer there. I use B9 Creation, and this is the result image that I would like to show you. After that, I cast them and get rid of the sprue, and this is the starting for finish. At the very beginning, you're going to find out on the casting, you have some line created by the printing layer. Depends on the resolution that you have, you always will end up with some small line. And those lines are easy to remove by sandpaper. Here's my homemade sandpaper. I'm wrapping a stick with 280 grit sandpaper. Make sure they are flat and tight. And I'm just going to some larger area. You don't have to worry too much inside because my stone is not transparent. So I just need to make sure outside is nice and polished before I actually get into the stone setting. You can see I try to smooth out as much as possible, and then you can go a little bit finer after this one. You can go up to 400 grit. Anything after that, I think it's just personal preference. I would like to use polish machine to do the rest of the job. After that, I will use the brown polish wheel. I bought this from the Rio Grande, and I will put the link below for you to check out them. Everybody have a different preference. I've been using this for a while. This is a little bit abrasive, so if you have minor scratch, it will be easy to remove. Be really careful on one thing, is anything is abrasive that create heat. So if your stone is heat sensitive like opal, then you will be really careful once you have a stone in there using this wheel, and I will show you just in few minutes. Now we finish the outside, that's cleaning the inside a little bit. You may have some rough surface left from the casting, so we don't have to polish inside because it's opaque stone. However, I would like to remove any of the bumpy surface inside if possible. So here I'm trying to use the ball bear to clean up inside and try to rough the surface a little bit. My stone is very soft, so if inside is not completely flat or you have any of the imperfection close to the edge, when you try to push the metal against it, then you will crack the stone. And double make sure the size is correct using the plastic hammer on the ring mandrel to shape the ring. If your ring is not smooth, you can use the file, and I usually use half round file to smooth out the bottom, especially where you had the sprue in there, and sometimes when you just cut off the sprue, it is not smooth. So I want to make sure the ring shank is tapered down smoothly, so I just wanted to work on it a little bit. The same rubber wheel, you can shape it into the smaller size or use the old one. And you can shape the rubber wheel with a piece of the old file and use that for shaping it. And here I want to make sure all the corners nice and round, so it's not gonna cut into the finger or scratch the finger when the customer wear it. And once again, it's a lot of back and forth filing, smoothing, and make sure everything's nice and perfect before we get into the polish machine. And I just realized my focus is on the stone sitting behind it, not necessarily on the ring. So I apologize for not super focused on the ring. So here I try to fit it and see if that fit well. So the ring looks fit really well. Let's get on the buffing wheel. And again, sorry to lose the focus. We want to polish every part I was using the white diamond, and then I jump into Fablister, and I will put the link here in the bottom. And this is the image of the polish compound that I was using. Now let's get to the stone setting. First of all, examine it and make sure everything's nice and polished. Because the wall is pretty thick for 1 millimeter or close to 0.8 millimeter, so I like to use parallel plier to bend them first, because it's almost impossible just push it against it. The regular bezel pressure is not going to work because the thick wall looking. So I try to get it as close as possible that I can still slice the stone in. So pretty much is the top, I try to bend it. The film is in 2x to 3x speed, so you don't have to sit in the whole section, but I just want to show you some key point of them. So there will be a lot of trying fitting, it won't be done at just once. At final, we put the stone, and I would like to tighten it a little bit more. Because of the thickness on the wall, I won't use the bezel pusher, so I actually use the hammer to hammer on it. Be really careful the angle that you are hammer on it. If you hit the stone will crack right there. What I do is I use my finger to cover the stone, so if it does hit the stone, it will hit my finger first. You're rather to have a bruised finger instead of a cracking stone. And don't try to hammer it too hard at once. What we like to do is bring it in close one by one. So you want to hit at 3 o'clock and then 9 o'clock and 12 o'clock and come back to 6 o'clock. This orientation like multiple times. You don't want to push, for example, 3 o'clock all the way, so your stone will be crooked or it won't be centered. Again, make sure you hit it at the right angle. You don't want it the corner to hit the stone. And sometimes it is really helpful if you have a smaller face of the hammer instead of a big face. When we get into the tight corner, instead of using a hammer, I will get a tracing hammer and with the tracing tool, and then that will have the better control. So I will having a hammer hitting on the end of the tracing hammer to push the stone down to tighten it. And this is actually the point you tighten the stone and make sure that the stone is not moving, then we can go into the polish process. Once again, I'm using the rubber wheel here. The rubber wheel will create heat, and this is really heat sensitive stone. So make sure that your finger is always somehow testing the temperature on the ring that you are setting. You can see my finger is always sitting there to make sure that it's not getting too hot. If I feel it's too warm or too hot, I will really quickly to stop it. We want to get rid of all the hammer mark that we have, and that's why I have this thick wall so I can kind of smooth it out into the angle that I like. And I like to have everything nice and round and more like an egg shape. So you can see that I try to getting to not only remove the hammer mark, but also smooth it out to the side. And once it is tight and everything is smooth out, we can go into the polish one more time. I'm using the white diamond first and then Fablister to shine up the ring. Since we already have it pre-polished and always need to have a high polish before you set a stone. So when we the second time when we polish, we just need to polish off where we leave the hammer mark. So your stone has the last chance to get too much of heat. Thank you for watching. There are more making videos on those link here. I hope you enjoy. Please like, share, and comment on my video. Let me know how I'm doing and what else you would like to see in my channel. Thank you for watching. I will see you next.